starting here. This is where I have my potatoes. And what I have learned since my horrible harvest with my little tiny tomatoes, not tomatoes, potatoes, was that cucumbers and potatoes are not companion plants. So I think the cucumber maybe affected it. But I do still think this soil was really compact. As you can see with all these big chunks that are still, well, it's dry. I haven't been watering this. But it had all these big old chunks in there. So I want to amend the soil by adding some perlite and maybe some sand or something to just make it a little less compact. It's just going to be me experimenting. I'm not telling anyone what to do. I'm not an expert. I'm just figuring things out as I go and doing a whole lot of experimentation, especially for the purpose of saving money. So for this, I'm going to add perlite and some clay sand and just mix it in here, and hopefully that'll be a better thing to grow in. Although the cucumber did really well, but at the expense of the potatoes. But I still think the soil was very compact. Anyway, so here's a jalapeno I have in this 17-gallon container. I did connect it to the drip irrigation finally. And yeah, just ignore this mess. It's gonna be like this until it cools down, because I've been planning to put back that raised bed that I took out because I want to grow more in the soil, but I'm tired. It's hot. It's gonna wait until at least next month when we'll have temperatures in the 90s mostly. Anyway, all these containers on this ledge have been neglected. Well, starting here. So these that I had pansies in, I haven't been watering these. They are totally dust at this point. They're crusty, dusty, they dead. And then down here, just weeds anyway. I haven't been watering that either. But here, I have that volunteer tomato on the end, and I have lavender. And I have them connected to the drip irrigation, so they have been okay. And I'll also, let me touch on, so I have this cantaloupe here. There's two cantaloupes in here actually. And I know these leaves are very light, so I'm gonna be putting some 511 in these, and most of these for the cantaloupe, all the melons and my peppers and also my fruit plants. So I'm gonna do that this evening when it gets a little cooler. All right, so, but they are still growing, but they're not really growing really well, and the leaves are kind of light. But I do have drip irrigation connected to this container. And then over here, because I want to go over here because otherwise I may skip it or forget it. So this is where I have these flowers. I think these are zinnias and cosmos, I think I put in here. Anyway, as you can see, they did not fare well here. This location gets 6+ hours of sunlight in this triple digit temperature. So yeah, this isn't a good spot for these particular flowers. I want to grow flowers in this spot, but I'm gonna look for some that can tolerate the heat over the summer. And of course in the fall and winter, spring, I'll be able to grow, have more flexibility, but I gotta find something that could survive this heat for the summer. And I don't want to just use the same flowers that I use in my front yard. And also I have some in the back, the zincas, that you'll see in a minute. I wanted more variety in this spot. So anyway, so that was something I'll keep trying to figure out what I'll put here. This green container is some oregano, which was store-bought from last year. I want something else in that container, or actually maybe something else in that spot, since it gets so much sunlight. So I don't have that on the drip yet, but I probably will add it because something's gonna go there. All right, so back to over here where the greenhouse frame is. I'll come over here. Phew, it's hot. All right, you can see my peppers are doing totally fine, and I need to do another harvest. Oh yeah, I did a harvesting video. That's what I did. Only thing I've done recently. And I need to harvest some more. Yeah, these are jalapenos, lots of flowers, some peppers. I've harvested some more, but I think the heat, you know, is affecting. I don't know. These things are supposed to be doing well in all this heat, but I'm not getting as many peppers. But anyway, I may be watering too much with the drip. Looking at these leaves, I'm still figuring it out, but it's been so helpful not having to manually water. Although I do go through and like spot water and just looking to make sure everything is actually getting water. So that's the peppers over here. It's I think 6 pepper plants, and or maybe 7. Anyways, way too many. So next year I will try to do, if these survive the winter, I'll move some of these, but I want just like 4 plants in this. And so I have the ground cherry. It is producing ground cherries. There go one that's almost ready. I could probably actually harvest that. So 2 ground cherries in here. My lemon plant actually does have lemons. I thought that possum that was in my backyard a while ago ate up all my lemon flowers, but there are some lemons on here. At least 2 that I thought. Anyway, I don't see the second one. Oh, there's at least 1 other one. So there are at least 2 lemons on this tree, the second year I've had it. Then my blueberries are changing colors, lighter, getting lighter. I'm not sure if they've been overwatered or it's a nutrition issue. So I'm gonna hit everything with some 511, but I also wanna work on my watering, make sure I'm not watering too much, because again, like the peppers have, that could be sunburn too, I don't know. Anyway, let me go over here. All right, let me go through. Well, all right, I'll come over here. I'm trying to avoid being directly in the sun. I was also trying to avoid walking through this watermelon patch where everything in here has spilled all over into this area. You can see I have lots of melons growing. Not any huge ones yet, but they'll get there eventually. Anyway, so let me walk up through here. And my melons, hashtag watermelon wars. I have some lightness on some of these leaves too, so I don't want to be over watering. Okay, let's see. Yeah, so tricky getting through here with these, how everything's growing. All right, so yeah, I also have to get something up here to catch that before it gets too heavy and drops. But yeah, so the watermelons are definitely growing over here. I don't have much growing except for the lavender. And then this eggplant started doing a whole lot better with the drip irrigation. I do have these other containers connected even though nothing's in them. Yeah, even the beans died. So anyway, I just have them connected for now. I am gonna still change this area out. I have a raised bed I wanna put here. And I actually want this to be my potato bed, I think that's what I'm gonna use it for, just so it'd be deeper, and so hopefully I'll get more potatoes. Anyway, I should have done that a long time ago, but it's hot. I'm tired. I ain't wanna do it yet. So anyway, I'll get to it. Here's my other pepper bed, the round one. This is the one I worry about not getting enough water. I did change the drip irrigation to come from this side. So I have 3 branches on the drip irrigation. Okay, so I have the main one, well, the original one that I started on this side of the side garden along the fence over here. And this bed was initially connected to over here, but I switched it to over on this side just because there's a lot less stuff over here. The only thing I have over here is the watermelon, this section, and now the pepper bed, which has some light leaves in there. and a spider or something there. Anyway, so yeah. And then back here in the back, the other watermelon that are spilling out of that section and totally covering all of this up, and even where the strawberry bed is over here in that pink container. I also have this morning glory that I keep tearing out of here. So it's the battle with this morning glory. All these vines here in the front, this morning glory. So I'm gonna have to beep, you know, all this growing up here is morning glory. So all this is gonna be snatched out soon. And then I have watermelons, of course. Another one back there. I know there's another one on the ground back there that's hard to get to, that I need to go ahead and check, because that was the first one I saw and it's probably ready, may have been ready, but yeah, I got to get through all of this to get to it. But I'm going to start taking out, well, I've already been, I'm like constantly taking out, go in house. Thank you. It's too hot for them to be out here. My dogs are old. They don't need to have their behinds in there in the AC. So let me make sure the other one's indoors. They usually have enough sense to go in there. They come out, do their business, and go back inside. But every now and again, they come out and like try to sunbathe in 107 temps. What the heck? My neighbor's doing something over there. Don't know what that is. Must be water. Somebody has a pool over here. At least one pool is open. Anyway, back to this. Ooh, I didn't see this melon. That one's gonna be bigger. But yeah, I'm gonna have to make my way into this. I'm gonna have to pull out this morning glory. So I'll be working on that tonight, later, when it gets a little bit cooler. All right, so here's the main strawberry bed, which isn't expanding as much as I had hoped it would, and look like a weed is in the middle, so it gotta get snatched out. So yeah, I have to be constantly fighting these weeds. But yeah, mostly the morning glory in this corner, but also there used to be a shrub over here that I had removed, but the stump is still here, so it keeps trying to grow back. So anyway, I should have wore a headband or something, because I'm sweating a bunch. It's my sign to go indoors. Oh, but here, these are my flowers that I like, the vincas. So I'm probably going to move these over there, since I know they will tolerate the heat, especially if they're getting water. So hopefully it won't be too bad to transplant them in all this heat. I'm going to go ahead and move them in that flower bed, just so there'll actually be some living flowers in there instead of the, you know, the roasted crusty stems that are in there right now. Okay, anyway, so let's go over to the side garden. All right, this has been more neglected even than the other side. My strawberries over here have been roasted. Still alive enough, I think they'll survive the next 2 weeks of this. There, every time they say it's 2 more weeks, it changes to 2 more weeks. It's like never ending heat, but I know it will end. This shall pass. All right, so I have the pepper plant here. I think that's the bell pepper. Anyway, it ain't made much progress. My kale is still here through all this heat, so I'm gonna remove most of this stuff at some point. I will replant the kale. The parsley is in here, but not doing very well. But those, oh my God, look at the grasshopper. I am so tired of these grasshoppers. It's like looking at me. I hate these bugs. And what the hell? I hope those people are okay. Sound like somebody collided. Well, anyway. So yeah, this is what neglect does in heat. But it is getting watered, so it's not dead. But even that cucumber in the middle is actually still alive. So, yeah. Eggplant over there, still alive. That tomato plant dough that I never lifted up because it was growing into the parsley. Oh yeah, what I was saying is that those butterfly, those caterpillars were over here. The swallowtail caterpillars, so I didn't want to disturb them, so I just kind of left this as is. I don't know if they made it or not. Alright, I stopped watering these things. I stopped watering anything that wasn't growing. So these haven't been watered. I do water the herbs still, even though they're not doing very well. Basil. And this has a tomato in here that's not doing very well, but it is producing tomatoes. And then this one has a tomato that's not really producing, but it's connected to the drip irrigation. So these things can bounce back in the fall or next month when the temperatures start dropping. Another grasshopper. I hate these bugs. All right, so that was a quick update of what is going on in my garden. Right now, I'm also gonna be dropping some seeds, which I should have been done, but I hadn't done that either. I have stuff ready. I wanna do some hydroponics indoors. No soil indoors, but I'm going to be using, I was gonna use some of this soil to do seedlings, but I need to amend it. So I haven't done anything yet, but I'm gonna be dropping seeds soon. We have a long growth season. Our first frost isn't until sometime in November. So I think we're gonna be all right. All right, anyway, thanks for watching, y'all.